All right, we live. Welcome to another episode of From My Experience Podcast. This is your boy, Rob. I have a special guest with me today. I don't know if she want to use her real name, so we're just going to call her Miss E. Miss E, how are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
Why you said you was nervous before we started recording?
Because I'm just, I don't know. You do this all the time. It's a little bit new to me. So, yeah. That's all.
You whack. All right. Nah, it's nothing, man. It's really nothing. It's not that serious. All you gotta do is be your normal, charming self. How about
that's
that?
For you to say you talk to people all the time.
Who, me?
You're talking to people when you're selling them something, or you're talking to people when you DJ, and so you're in front of a crowd of people. You have a podcast that can be heard from anywhere in the world, so you're not going to be nervous, are you?
Them people ain't in front of me right now, though.
Oh, my goodness.
Anyway, how's your life been?
I won't complain. Just like the song said, it could always be better, but it could definitely always be worse. So, I definitely won't complain. I have some things to smile about. So, yeah, we're good.
Word. What you think about this heat, though?
This heat I'm not loving. But I guess when you complain about the cold, you know, you kind of get what you ask for. So I wasn't feeling freezing my tail off. So I guess, you know, I'm here with the heat.
Listen, I can take the cold all day. Because, like, the cold is, like, you can adjust to the cold better. You got heat in your car. You got heated seats. You can go inside, put on more blankets. But when you hot, the AC is only going to do so much. It's only going to do so much.
I don't know. My apartment feel lovely.
It's not the same. It's not.
Plus, you, I mean, you come on now. You start off in the north. I'm southern all my life. Getting adjusted to cold weather.
No, I started down here, and then when I went up there, I started loving it. But now it's like I get cold easily. Now my blood done got thin. So it's whack. What we said we was gonna talk about? I had it all down pat yesterday, and then I forgot.
I want to say what we said we were gonna talk about is the question, why men don't marry, or why is it that men don't get married?
Oh, that Facebook post.
Yes, that was posted in
the screenshotted it.
Podcast, so I got it here.
Oh, I sent her a picture of my... Hold on.
You sent her a picture of your what?
Huh?
Oh my goodness, stop sending people...
I don't know what you're talking about. Alright, so here's what the post said. It said, why men don't marry. They only have reason number two. Because there's nothing in it for them. What exactly does marriage offer men today? Men know there's a good chance they'll lose their friends, their respect, their space, their sex life, their money, and if all goes wrong, their family, says Helen Smith, PhD, author of Men on Strike. They don't want to enter into a legal contract with someone who could effectively take half their savings, pension, and property when the honeymoon period is over. Men aren't wimping out but by staying unmarried or being commitment phobes. They're being smart. These are quotes, by the way, y'all. Unlike women, men lose all power after they say, I do. Their masculinity dies, too.
Don't respond.
I agree with some of that.
With some of it, right?
I agree with some of that, and because I've seen it, like it's funny when you're around a married couple or with a married couple, and I know people who are married. I ain't gonna air none of y'all out. Not that y'all talking shit about your wives or anything, but like, there's definitely a huge change. Now, I don't think marriage is a disadvantage to a guy, but a marriage to the wrong woman can be a huge disadvantage. But I'm not going to go into my details. You're the guest. I want to get your take on this.
I could see where some of that would come into play. I could definitely see why some of that would be believed. I do think it's interesting. I'm kind of assuming that Helen Smith, of course, is a woman. That's what I'm assuming. So I think it's kind of interesting seeing it, you know, coming from a woman's perspective. And she actually breaks it down a little bit further. I actually found her blog post on Huffington Post. And this was back from 2013. And so it states those same reasons the loss of respect, losing out on sex, losing friends, losing space, losing your kids and your money, losing in court, and losing your freedom, and mentioning that single life is better than ever. I think it's really just been given a very negative connotation, marriage in this perspective. Why not highlight the good points of marriage? The same way you say a man can miss out on respect or support, a lot of times men find respect and support from relationships with other people, mainly other with women.
I agree.
So sometimes when you don't have that support, whether it's from family, whether it's from friends, sometimes you get in very healthy relationships and that person builds you up beyond what you ever expected. I don't think you necessarily lose out on sex. I think the sex drive changes as you get older. I think when you're younger, of course, you tend to have more sex, but as you get older and you start working, you start having all these other things that you're investing in, I just think that it doesn't become such a priority, whereas when you're a teenager and you first start and you're experimenting.
I ain't started as no teenager, McNasty. Okay.
Young adult. Young adult. Whatever, Rob. You know what I'm saying, when you're younger, okay? For those who did start when they're younger. Some people started when they were older. But yeah, I just think it wants to highlight on some of the negative things that can happen, but I mean,
right, I'm gonna take it line by line. They'll lose their friends. Yo, if your wife don't like that friend, they gotta go.
I'm sure she has a reason for not liking that friend. One of the things it says in legitimate. The blog, it says,
go ahead.
When married, men's ties with friends from school and work tend to fade. Although both men and women lose friends after marriage, so they both do, it tends to affect men's self-esteem more. Perhaps because men tend to be less social in general.
I can agree with that. Like, I've never been married, but I was in a relationship where my friendships definitely took a hit because of it. Because she wanted so much of my time, and she was, I don't know why, but she was worried about what I was doing with my friends. I'm like, if I was going to cheat or whatever, like, if I don't want to be with you, I'm just not going to be with you. It's not that serious. Like, we're too intertwined and know too many of the same people for me to cheat on you, because it's going to make me look bad in all of my circles. And beyond that, I'm not that type of person. But yeah, and that's the other thing. Like, if they don't like your friends, it's always going to be awkward. You're never going to have them over. You know it's going to be an issue or argument whenever you hang out with said friend. And like you said, there may be a reason, but is it a legitimate reason? Maybe she don't like that friend because he told her ass the truth one time and she ain't like that. Maybe, you know what I mean, he cracked a joke and she don't like it. But it's like, that don't mean it's a valid reason for you not to like them. But you can't pick nobody over your wife. Like, ever. That'll cause problems forever. So, that statement is low-key true. But we're talking about men. We're not talking about women here.
I think it's true.
To an extent.
I think, too, it could be from the perspective of wanting you to have better. Like, if it's something that she sees wrong with your friends. Like, if it's a... Like, if I was married and I, you know, if my husband had friends that I felt weren't good for who he was or who he was trying to become, I would probably say something about it. That's just my thinking.
I guess, man.
For instance, like,
I'm just getting pissed off thinking about it.
You have a family now. So some of the things that you used to
do. You might not be married. You might not have kids yet.
But you and your wife are a family.
Fuck all that. All right. Nexus says, I'm kidding. Nexus says they'll lose their friends.
What about mutual friends? Like, it's when you're
shit, y'all become everyone. Y'all friends kind of merge.
What I was say. They so mer- I feel like if you expose your wife to your friends enough, maybe that's where the issue comes in, and she feels like she doesn't know them. And that's why the trust issue is there. But maybe if she knows your friends, like if she's legitimately been around them, she can see what you love about them. She sees their personality and stuff. That could totally change how she feels about you hanging out with that person. If she's developed her own relationship or her own sense of trust with that person.
Stop making that face like, I wish y'all could see her face. That's true.
Turn the camera off.
That is true. No, you're right. What you just said is actually, that's a good point. That's very true.
Like, stop hiding your friend, because then it makes it seem like you got something to hide.
That can be true, too. And it also says they'll lose their respect. I don't really understand that. I kind of want to skip that, because I don't understand how you...
This is what it says.
And she did more research on the back.
But today, fathers are figures of fun more than figures of respect. The chubby guy with the flower diaper bag, blah, 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 is no better in the news media. As communication professor James, whatever, reports, 69% of mass media reporting and commentary on men was unfavorable, compared with just 12% favorable and 19% balanced. Yeah, that don't make sense to me. Like, the media, they're mentioning the media in the blog, but I'm like, the media is always going to point people out to be whatever they want them to be. I don't think a man loses respect, but I will say this, and it's something I point out a lot of times.
Okay.
If you want to be king of a castle, you have to know how to rule the castle.
What'd that mean?
Like, you have to assert yourself in that position or in that order. Like, one thing about me, I can never handle a weak man.
What is a weak man?
I am very opinionated. I am very boisterous.
What is a weak man?
Huh?
What is a weak man?
Here you go. Like,
you gotta give the people context.
I think men should make I've always dreamed of, if I had a husband, like, I would like for him to be a true head of the household. Okay. Like, I would like for him to consult me on things, but at the end of the day, I feel like a large majority of decisions should come from him.
So you want him to tell you to sit your ass down?
If I need to sit my ass down, I mean...
Wow. Fellas, like, you hear that? You hear that?
Off the handle, like, sometimes you need that balance. That's what I'm saying. I'm not talking on no abuse stuff, and I hope everybody can understand.
Yeah, she doesn't want to get...
understand what I'm saying, but you get what I'm saying for real?
Yeah.
Like, your husband has to be that balance to you. Mm-hmm. So if you are acting irate about something, or if you're getting overly frustrated about something, like, he needs to step in and be like, you know, hey, chill out, sit down, you know, calm your nerves. Like, that's what I expect.
Okay. Their space. Men lose their space. Abso-frickin-lutely.
That's what a man cave is.
Listen. Okay, so I'm in the real estate profession. I've seen enough homes to know that the man cave, number one, you're lucky if you get a man cave. Typically, it's the garage, which don't count, because that ain't heated and cooled. And if somebody parked their car in there, you don't have it. But the man cave is either really, really small, or it is now a playroom, or the wife's office, or something. Like, the men, you definitely lose your space. Like, even in, I have to use my last relationship as reference. Again, I wasn't married, but... there was a room over the garage that she said I could put my stuff in, because when we moved in or whatever, I got rid of all my stuff. I had a TV and a fucking computer desk. That was it. The rest of the house, she did whatever she wanted to do, whatever. And even in the man cave, after a while, things started creeping up there. And then it became, I can put my office over here in this corner. And I'm just like,
say no, like, this my room.
I did. But it's like, at the end of the day, how many times do you want to have this argument? How many times do you want to have this fight? Like, and it's personality types and all kind of shit. But yeah, you're right. Now, it's different. I mean, the biggest circumstance was different. It was her house. So there's only so much I can really say. Because it's like, do you really want to bring that argument about or whatever? Or do you want someone to feel uncomfortable in their quote-unquote house? It was jacked up. It was, well, I wouldn't say it was jacked up, but it was just a situation I was in. I was like, you know what? Eh, no. Now, if we bought the house together, then that'd been different. Or if it was my house, it probably would have been different. But yeah, I definitely, it's funny you say that. I have to have my space. Like, I'm a gamer. I'm a DJ. Like, I gotta put that stuff somewhere. Like, I need a studio / office. I have to have that. Like, that's like a no. Like, if you, I don't even care if you have an inkling in your mind that, well, I might want an office one day. Okay, well, then we need to get 5 bedrooms. Because this is going to be my office whether you like it or not. Like, it has to be like that.
And that's that conversation of mutual respect. Like, it's a, if you say up front, I need this space. Like, mm-hmm. this is what I'm doing with this space. And I feel that that should be respected, and vice versa. If I want a little sewing room, even though I'm so, mm-hmm. you know, but if I, whatever little room I want, that should be my little space and my little room. And you're right. You do have to get spaces that accommodate that. But I don't think, I would hate for a man to feel like, dang, I don't have any privacy. I don't have anywhere I can go. Oh yeah.
Yeah. And ladies
but
and gentlemen,
that's kind of real estate fault too, ain't it? Y'all making all these open concept, all these open floor plans and stuff.
No, that's that dude fought on the front end. Like, cause, and that is funny. That's why I kind of agree with this article. Like, I've been around a lot of married couples, and I'm not there, you know, after, you know, whatever. I don't live with y'all, but just in conversation, the woman makes a lot of the decisions. If she don't like it, he goes along with it. It's crazy. But off of that, off of the space, their sex life, yeah, there's okay, their sex life, their money, and their family. All right, sex life. I'm not even gonna talk about that bullshit. That's a scary thing. Not necessarily true, because I've had, shout out to Nika and Wes, who've been on the show. I need to get them back on. They were saying how they're friends with older couples, and they're basically, they said they're friends with older couples and they've talked to some things. And one thing they say they don't do is, even if they're angry with each other, they don't use sex against each other. Like, you know, I don't care how mad I am at you. If you want some, you're going to get some, and then I can turn my roll over. That's fine. A lot of women will use that, I think, as a weapon.
Mm-hmm.
You know, oh, well, you ain't getting none. I'm upset. Well, you're not getting none. Now, think about it. You're my wife. You're my only source. You're supposed to be my slut, my freak, my hoe at the house. You know what I'm saying? You're supposed to be all of that. And you withholding because you feel some type of way. I think that is real fucking corny, because it can lead to other things. But I think that's extremely corny.
Like infidelity.
And the other thing, fellas, you got to remember, you know what I'm saying, who you're marrying. Like, if she wasn't smashing like that before y'all got married, you know, do y'all have that sexual chemistry? That's important. Their money, I mean, that's a two-way street. Well, first of all, let me say, friends, I think the female friends thing, I don't think that's as much as of a two-way street. Respect. Ladies also can suffer the respect thing, depending on how that man treats them. The women never lose any goddamn on space. That's for damn sure. Y'all get more space if any damn thing. Sex life. The money. Oof. Marriage is expensive.
I'm sure.
And I ain't never been married. But yeah, you will find yourself spending money on some shit. What are you looking at?
The research, dude. I'm fully into the conversation. I hear you.
Okay, people hear me all the time. They want to hear your opinion. A man's money. How you feel about that?
I do feel that men should be providers.
What?
On the large scale of things.
On a large scale? What?
Like, you talk about mortgage.
Okay.
I would be completely okay with if my husband says, well, I do mortgage.
Well, shit, yeah, you be okay. That's one of the biggest damn bills.
You do utilities. But you're the provider. You're the man.
Okay, well, see, you know what? The type of woman you are, though, it makes sense because you'll play your role. Some people want you to do that shit and they ain't gonna play their role.
And see, I guess I get called old school because those are the relationships that I saw and those are the relationships that I believe in. Mm-hmm. Like, as far as you, now don't get me wrong, my parents were never married. But for the first part of my life where my parents were together and actually lived together, that's what I saw was that mutual distribution of funds. Like, there was no, like, to me, if you're going to take care of a man or if you're going to pay the majority of bills, I feel like you might as well be single because you're doing it by yourself anyway. So I do believe that, you know, I do a large part of homemaking. You do a large part of, you know, going out, bringing home the bacon, so to speak. I do believe in that.
What if you make more money than him?
If I make more money than him, he still can pay the mortgage? That might just be, that's what I'm saying. That might be his only responsibility, though.
It's not fair, but you're right. I hear
but
you.
But if you're doing mortgage, okay, depending on whatever, you know, okay, you're doing mortgage. If I'm doing a car note, the car insurance, all that, the home insurance, that stuff is going to balance itself out.
No, it doesn't.
Why doesn't it?
It depends. So, number one, you're not wrong in what you're saying. It depends. That's a conversation you got to have with your woman. And fellas, that's one thing I'm putting my foot down about is the fucking finances. Like, me and my ex, we split. We had that shit down to a fucking science. Like, we were like, all right, here's our mutual bills. Here's exactly what I make. Here's exactly what you make. Here are my individual bills. I'm gonna keep over here. You keep your individual bills over there. What we did was we did the Susie Orman calculator. So what Susie Orman came up with was you pay a percentage of the mutual bills based off your income so that it's fair. So like if you're making $100,000 a year and I'm making $50,000 a year and I'm spending, you know, $10,000 a month on bills and you spending $10,000 a month on bills, it's not fair because that leaves me with $40,000 while you're left with $90,000. So it splits it to where whoever's making more, you pay a bigger percentage of your salary so that it balances out, so that it's equal. Because like if I'm only making like $2,000 a month and the mortgage is $1,600, I got $300 for the rest of the month. Versus if we split it and it current comes up and determines, okay, well, I need to pay $700 and you need to pay $800 or whatever. It balances. And when we did it, like I was like, oh, okay. Because she made a hell of a lot more money than I did. You know, I was a teacher. So, so when it came, and the funny thing is, when she kind of frowned at it. It was her idea. It wasn't my idea. I think it was my idea. But anyway, when we looked at it, we were both able to spend the money comfortably, split the bills comfortably, pay our own bills, and there is money left over for both of us to save money. Yeah. Like, it was great. It was great. That's what I believe in.
And I would be totally open to that. I think my biggest thing is just making sure that everybody pulls their weight. Now, I know I don't think it's fair that I get to keep my whole check. That's not what I'm saying at all.
Right.
That makes no sense to me. Because all you're doing is putting more stress and more burden on one person. And when you start to put that amount of stress and that much of a burden on a person, you're destroying the relationship. Mm-hmm. There is no mutual input in that relationship at that point. Mm-hmm. So at that point, if he wants to say, well, look, the bottom floor is my man cave, then it's definitely his because he has all his money poured into everything, the bills, the mortgage, whatever like that. So yeah, I like that idea of using that percentage base that you mentioned. I think that was a great idea because you want it to be that way. And at the same time, I feel like you should never, if you're married to a person, you have to be prepared at any time to step in and assist that person. Exactly. Like a man should never feel like if something happens with work, because things happen with work, you get tired of certain work situations. Like a man should never have to worry about, okay, if I leave this job, I'm going to another job. Now he got to go to another job. Let's be clear. Or either start his own company. He should be able to hold things down while he's transitioning.
I agree.
And it shouldn't be held over his head. it shouldn't be a comeback and say, well, remember when you weren't working March, April, or May, I paid the mortgage. Like, that shouldn't even be a conversation.
I agree 1,000%. And y'all need to set a savings goal. And the other beautiful thing about that bill calculator, you know how much your bills cost for the month. It's one number. You're going to have an overall number. The other person will have an overall number. So you know, all right, $700 covers all of our household bills. Like, we put that money in the bank account, bong, done. The household bills are taken care of. Now, if I was married, we just would have put everything in a pot. But since we weren't, I kept my car insurance and my car payment and all that crap separate. But, all right. Their money, their family. I love my family. I hope none of them are listening. My family, my family's loved everyone I've been with, except for one person. I'll put it like this. If my family does not like your spouse, they won't always take it out on you. They might get on your nerves about it a little bit, but mm-hmm. I've never seen my family cut someone off or completely shun them because of who they were married to. But it has definitely caused some drama. And the funny thing is, I get it, but I don't get it. Some people don't like it because, like you said, if the man puts his foot down, like, hey, you're not going to be giving your mama or your daddy or your little brother all of our damn money every time they ask, then they take it out on him. They don't like him because she's making her stand up for himself. Right, but he's doing the right thing. Now, if it's because of the way he's treating you or something like that, well, hold on. The man losing his family. So, okay. I mean, if my aunts and my mom and them don't like my wife, I mean, that's not a reason for them not to talk to me. And I would want to know what the reasoning is. Like, that one I really don't get. I guess I can get it. I guess if they feel like she's a gold digger and he don't see it, and they just, I don't know. That's a weird one.
That's what they're talking about, is if your family doesn't necessarily care for that person. I think something that happens a lot of times, and I'll be honest, I have to make a confession. I avoid mama's boys. I have a fear of dating a mama's boy because in the back of my mind, like, I'm at that age where I want to be married. Not even if it's not necessarily now, within like a year or two, I'm at that point where I want to start dating a person for the purpose of marriage. Mm-hmm. At this point, I don't have any time to wait. But like, if I'm talking to you, I'm looking to marry you. But my fear with dating a person who is very close to their mother is that she's always going to be first. And I feel like when you get married, your wife is now the person, bless you.
Thank you.
First.
I agree.
And so when I see guys who are mama's boys, I mean, and there's nothing wrong with being close to your mother. You know, I admire that. I think mm-hmm. that's a great thing, to be close to a parent. And stuff, and to have that relationship. Plus, you know, they say how a man treats his mom and how he treats his sisters is how he'll respond to you. So that's great. You know, if he has that love and admiration for women in general, that he shows them that respect. But if I feel like, dang, you know, every holiday we going to your mama house, every Sunday we going to your mama house, oh, you finna go over your mama house, like, it's you always your mom.
Yeah.
That's a problem. I would have a problem with that.
I agree.
I would have a serious problem with that.
I need to see that. One, their relationships. I learned this from somewhere. Oh my God, hold on.
Wake up. Stay with me.
Listen, man. I've been working 12-hour days all week. One thing I learned is from Russ, actually. It's funny, I never really thought about it, but he was like, if you look at the girl's relationship, or you look at the person's relationship with their parents, especially the parent of the opposite sex, that'll show you the type of relationship you'll have with them. And it's creepy, because that shit is true. Like, when I reflect on my two serious relationships, and I look at the way that they treated their dads, it's almost the same way they treated me. And it makes sense because that's the first man in their life to show them love and affection and all that. And that's the first relationship that they see. So they're a reflection of that. And when I think about how I treat my mom and how I am with my mom, yeah, that I take some of the, not necessarily the same, but some of those things. I take some of those traits and characteristics. I had a point and I kind of lost my train of thought. Oh, you said mama's boys. I don't like that either. Because it's always going to make me wonder about your loyalty to me as your husband, even though we're not married yet. I'm not saying you got to put me above your dad before marriage, but I need to see that the potential is there that, you know, a couple of times, take my side instead of his a couple of times just to show me, you know what I'm saying? Like if he's saying, oh, you know, you coming home for Christmas, I need to hear you say, nah, we're going to go to Rob's family's house, or nah, me and Rob, we're not going to come this time. Like, and I need you to do it. Don't make me be the asshole bad guy all the time.
Yeah.
Like, I need you to do it. I need to see that. I need to see that, okay, you can tell people no sometimes. You're not always going to make me do it because we're supposed to be a team.
And that's how one of my friends is that's married. They have specific holidays that they go to her people's house, and then they have specific holidays that they go to his people's house. And I remember when I was younger, I always thought of it as asking for permission at one point. Like, yeah. I thought, why do you have to ask? Like, if I would call and say, hey, I want to do something, she'd be like, oh, I got to check with such and such. And I'm like, you know, why do you have to ask your husband? Then I realized it wasn't such a permission thing. It's a mutual respect thing.
Mm-hmm.
It's a, you know, hey, I want to go and do this Wednesday, you know, especially if you have kids involved. You got to make sure kids are picked up from school. If they have practice or dance or cheerleading, basketball, whatever, you got to make sure your kids are picked up, that there's somebody to take care of them, if they have dinner. So I realized that a lot of it was just a mutual consideration for the other person's time and an understanding of what they're doing for the day. So I think the same thing goes with in-laws. You got to have a mutual consideration that we've already combined two families here. So time needs to be spent equally.
I agree. Yeah, you got to rotate the holidays and, excuse me, make them come see you. Moving forward, they don't want to enter into a legal contract with someone who could effectively take half their savings, pension, and property when the honeymoon period is over. Well, I mean, you can sign a prenup, so that'll eliminate that.
Okay, that's what I said. And the other thing, the other comment that I made in regards to that post is, who goes into marriage looking for a divorce? I feel like when you make that statement, or if that's a concern of yours, like, oh, if we get divorced, you know, she'll take part of my money. Why are you even thinking about that?
You have to think about that, though.
Well, like, if I go into the marriage, like, till death do us part, that's what it says. I'm not planning on divorcing you unless I just find out something just extremely horrible about you once the honeymoon is over. Like, I'm not trying to... I don't know. But like you said, I wouldn't mind signing a prenup, honestly. I wouldn't.
Yeah, I think unfortunately,
but I have my own foundation. That's the other thing. I can work for myself. I have my own certifications. I can take care of myself, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
Unfortunately, my past has taught me that it's fucked up, but my past has really taught me that I need a contingency plan. Like, I've been out on my ass, and it's like, recovering from that shit is not easy, and it takes a long time when you have to feel emotionally and financially at the same time. Like, that shit is fucking trash, because your financial life has an effect on your emotional life, too, and nobody wants to hit the reset button, and we ain't getting no younger, so age is always a factor. Yo, listen, side note. I was laughing at one of my bros, shout out to Rashad. He was put on Facebook that he had a gray hair in his beard, and I was laughing.
I saw it.
Because I got gray hair on my head, right? Tell me why I was in the mirror the other day, and I saw a fucking gray hair in my beard. I plucked his ass so fast. Like, beep! Like, where did he come from? Yo, I was like, nah, B, I can't do the salt and pepper face, yo. I'm not ready. My beard just started acting right last year. Now you want to already turn on me? No, I can't do that, son. But, sorry.
Yeah, because you had some struggles with that beard.
You know what? You know what? I did. So I have to own that. I did. It was terrible. But I used to, that's how my hair is always, man, anyway. Even the hair on top of my head, like, it's always a freaking struggle. That's why I just cut it and get rid of it. But that's funny. Yeah, I do. Because when I was doing my temp phase, I was balding right here.
Uh-huh.
And it, how you know?
What do you mean?
You nod your head and said, uh-huh. You noticed my bald spot when it...
Yeah, but why would I point it out? It's called pictures. I mean, you was good. You still look good. You good?
What pictures? You noticed it lately? What? What?
No,
but if you see,
you
it's...
said when. When refers to the past. You're good.
Like, how long? Good. Wait a minute. We're going to talk off the air. But no, when I cut all my hair off, I cut it all off. And now it's not there. It looks normal now. It's not there anymore. So I have no idea. But that's nothing to do with what we're talking about. Prenup. The reason I say you got to think about it, it depends on if you... I think you've... Well, I don't want to look at a person and say... First of all, if I feel like you might take half my shit if you leave me, it's twofold. Either you could be the type... It could be a personality type.
Mm-hmm.
Or it could be your gold digger type deal. Hopefully you'll recognize the gold digger. But it could be a personality type. Like, some people feel like if they invest their time, effort, and energy in you, they deserve something. Are they necessarily wrong? No. But do you necessarily think that they deserve what they're going to possibly get? Now, I plan on having a lot more assets and benefits in my life. And I'm probably going to want to do a prenup. But I will also want my spouse to be okay, because I'm the type of person, if it ends and it's over, like, let's talk about it. Let me see what I can hook you up with so that you're straight and that I'm still straight. Because that half and taking all that shit sucks. Like, I've sold a divorce house. Like, that shit.
Yeah.
It's trash, man. And I don't know what they base that stuff on. I feel like a lot of that stuff is opinionated, and it's just, at the end of the day, it's not fair.
People get so vindictive, I think, in some of those divorce proceedings. Like, it's like, I'm mad at this person.
Yep.
I'm upset with this person. So it's whatever I can do to hurt them, not thinking about the long-term effects. Sometimes it doesn't seem like they're really
and
concerned.
They're embarrassed.
There's children involved.
Oh,
It just gets very hurtful.
They're embarrassed too, because back to the family thing, and the family never liked them. And you got to hear, I told you so. I told you so. I told you so. And you got that one asshole sister. There's always, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, so it could definitely, ugh, yeah. But, all right, Miss E. I think that's it. Men are not wimping out by staying unmarried or being commitment phobes. They're being smart. Unlike women, men lose all their power. Now, I will say this. You do, some men, not all, you do lose some power when you get married. Like, your woman will push some buttons, and I think will stretch some things, and you'll definitely see a change. I do feel like you lose some of your power. I do. Now, the type of woman that you are, I don't think so. I think he'll have to be in power, or he risks losing you. But I have seen certain situations just like...
Are you talking about me now, or are you talking about college me?
No, you now.
Oh, okay.
You want a powerful guy.
But I'm a little bit more flexible.
But I've seen situations, and I've just looked at some marriages, and I'm just like, yo, she really just gonna let her dictate this and say that and like just like that? And I just say, you know what?
Don't wanna argue, don't wanna fight.
But some stuff is just like, come on, bro. Like, come on, dude. Like, just simple, small things. And it's like, you know what? You gotta create, I hate to say it like this. I hate to use the word train, but like, you got to teach someone how to love you.
Yes.
Like, you really got to work at that and do that. That statement is a bit extreme, saying you lose all the power. You don't. But, like, shit does have to shift, because, from my experience, women like to feel important. So sometimes they're going to want to win. Sometimes you got to let them win. But some of y'all take that shit too damn far. Y'all want to win all the damn time. And then you forget that this ain't about winning or losing, because we working together. So,
I was going to say, it's not about winning or losing.
But you'd be surprised. And y'all need to get rid of these damn outside influences. Stop listening to other people who don't know y'all relationship. Because you remember that.
Stop telling other people y'all relationship. Yep. Like, nobody could down your dude on anything unless you tell them about him.
Exactly.
And, like, I think it looks... One thing I can't stand, and this was a conversation that I had recently, like, around Father's Day. Like, I understand that people say that once you have a kid by a guy, that he changes, or something about him is different. And they say it about women, too. But vice versa, like, I believe that there was something that you saw before. You just maybe ignored it. Mm-hmm. Like, when a guy says, oh, my baby mama crazy, like she crazy. Mm-hmm. I'm like, no, she was always crazy. I'm like, and you saw that she was crazy. I said, there was something that she said or did that clicked in your head that was like, that's a little bit unstable. I said, but because you were enjoying, you know, whatever you were enjoying about her, you chose to ignore that little bit that you say, oh, it's just a little problem. You chose to ignore that, and now you're getting it full blown. But I always say, like, when women are bashing, like, the father of their children and stuff, like, I hate that. Like, I'm like, you know, just, it doesn't look good for you. It's not going to motivate them to do any better. Because if you sit up and you dog me out on social media, you told everybody about me, like, I'm not motivated to really, you know, be around or do anything at this point, because all you've done is torn me down. And yeah. Then it becomes that, like, I've actually been in a situation where I lost a friendship over that. Like, I had a friend who, the father of her child, I felt like she was doing some things that I totally disagreed with. Mm-hmm. For instance, with child support, it wasn't, you know, it was something they were trying to work out amongst themselves. Mm-hmm. And I realized that he changed, like, he used to give her cash.
Oh,
and
shit.
And when he would give her cash, when he get paid, that was, you know, so of course supposed to be used for the kids. Well, she would turn around and ask for more things. And he was like, well, where's the money? You know, that I just gave you. Well, it went to hair, it went to nails. This, you know, it's the truth.
No.
Yeah, she can say it's a lie if she wants to, but this is the truth. I know this for a fact. And so then what happened, he started buying Pampers himself. He started dropping off formula. He would go and get the things. Like, you say the girls need shoes, that's mm-hmm. what he goes and gets and brings
she
you the
ain't like that.
Versus, and exactly. And so then it became, I'm taking him to court.
Yep.
Why are you taking him to court? He's doing what he's supposed to be doing, but because you can't get the cash form of support for you to do what you would like to do with it, now it's an issue. And I had a huge problem with that. I had to eventually leave that person alone. It was something that I tried to, you know, I guess kind of salvage the relationship. Mm-hmm. But after a while, I realized there was just certain things about her I just didn't agree with. Like, I just, you know, rather than judge you or something, like, I just rather leave the situation alone.
I agree. You got to do that. And you got to check your friends sometimes. Like, I tell my friends when I think they're wrong and things of that nature. But you're right. Like, I'll never forget. I've said this a million times, but I'm going to say it again because, fellas and ladies, y'all need to listen to this. I remember when I met some of my exes, her closer friends, for the first time, and they really had a chance to really spend a little bit of time with me. And I forgot what we were doing. One of my bros was there. We was chilling at the house, blah blah blah, and we ordered them pizza and we were eating and laughing, having a good time. And one of them said, Rob, you're nothing like I expected you to be. Like, she was in genuine shock. And it hit me later that, well, shit, your only impression of me would have to come from her, my girl. It's the only impression of me. So I'm like, what the fuck she been saying? But you know what? I started paying more attention and I caught little stuff. Like, when you don't want to be on the phone with them, I get home from work or I just walk in the room. All right, girl, I got to go. Rob done came in here. Or Rob just got home from work. I'm going to call you back. Like, I expect you to get off. Like, you know what I'm saying? No, yeah, like, if you don't want to talk to your friend, just be like, look, make up your genuine lie. Say mama calling me or I'm going to get off the phone. Don't drag me into your BS. Don't do that. Because then I look like, you know, the mean guy. Like, oh, you can't talk to me. And that happened to my family. I ain't going to air nobody out. But that happened to my family one time. One of my aunts did that to my uncle. And he gave her this look because she said, oh, such and such home, I got to call you back. And I said, okay. And I was just like, huh, wonder why. But yeah, that just limit who you let in your relationship. All right, Miss E.
All in all, as a concisis, do you think...
Concisis?
Is that the right word? You can be the right word.
I'm so glad I'm recording this.
Something's up.
Concisis. You know what I mean. I'm naming this episode. The name of this episode is Concisis. I'm just letting you know. What do you mean? Definitely call it this episode Concisis.
It's Concisis. What did I say?
Is it? I thought it was Consensus.
Consensus. I don't know. Oh okay, but just to sum things up. Do you think that marriage overall would be a benefit or a detriment for you? Now, I know that word, detriment.
Oh, man. It's definitely a benefit. A partner is good. Shit, even in the bad times when I was in my relationship where we were splitting bills, I had way more money than I do now. Like, shit was a lot easier. I ain't gonna say a lot easier. Shit was different. Financially, it was better. But yeah, it's definitely a benefit. It's good to, you know, have someone around to have your back. Like, what if you get sick, or what if there is a rough month, you know? Yeah. And it's always good to have that support. And then you can have safe, unprotected sex. That's always a great thing. What?
Safe, unprotected. Okay.
Then you gotta be, you know, you ain't gotta be out here in these streets. You know what I'm saying? Oh, yeah, boy. Unprotected. Shit. I need you to get on birth control or something. Or safe, protected. Whatever. You know, trust me to pull out. Whatever.
It's this just. This does not work.
That works.
No. Okay. All right.
It's worked for me. I ain't got no little, that I know of. I ain't got no little wham wham running around. Nah, you can't be trying to wait till the last second, though. You got them thighs start tingling. You got to stop, bro.
Finish your summary.
This is part of the summary. Okay. It's just good to have someone who, you know, will split things with you down the middle, basically. I think overall it's definitely a benefit. And then, I mean, you know, for the benefit of the children. Like, nobody, I don't think anybody wants to really be a single parent. Like, that shit sucks. All right, what's your concisis?
I think that marriage is a benefit. You know, I hate that some people would even attempt to call it a negative thing. I think marriage is a beautiful thing with the right person.
Yep.
I think with the person that loves you, that a person trusts you, respects you, that they want both of you to grow together. They want to see you all have things and just be happy together and be a support for you and really welcome you into their family and share values with you and different things of that nature. I just see it as a beautiful thing with the right person. I think there has to be give and take on both sides. I don't think any marriage is going to be 100% perfect. And I think that's just something that you have to be prepared for. But yes, I do think marriage is a benefit to men and women. Oh yeah.
But especially women. All right, y'all. So, no, I'm kidding. It's mutual. Love y'all. We'll holla. Miss E, we'll have you back on in the future. See, that wasn't so hard. You was nervous for nothing.
And thank you for the invite. I enjoyed it.
Thank you for accepting my Slack last minute invite and reminding me of tonight, because I was definitely about to go to bed. And I've been getting fussed at when I don't be posting episodes. I got a couple of really good listeners. Shout out to CV, We Here Man, and Nella B. Make sure y'all go listen to We Here Man. They're on Anchor, iTunes, all those places. Go listen to them. They're a married couple who just talk about everything. Their married life. They have guests. They have really good shows. I know CV personally. Make sure you check them out. Miss E will have a book coming out. We don't have a release date yet, but definitely, you know, as she gets deeper into the writings of it, I'm going to have her back on to discuss that. I'm going to promote that. She looked at me just now like, I can't believe you just said that, my nigga.
But it's okay. Speaking into existence.
Yeah, you got to speak it into existence because it exists. You started writing it. You got a title, right?
Yeah.
All right, there you go. You started writing it. all right, we will catch y'all next time. Don't forget, From My Experience Podcast, join the Facebook group. We post a lot of stuff in there that we talk about on the show, and it's an open forum for y'all to discuss things. We're on Google Play, SoundCloud, Anchor, iTunes, Stitcher. We're a bunch of different places. If you have any questions, From My Experience Podcast at gmail.com if you want to be a guest or post any questions, and FME_podcast on Instagram. Follow us on there. We will catch y'all next time. Peace. Good night.